Hi.
Let's talk about the sacral plexus and one of its branches, the pudendal nerve. So the sacral plexus is going to be derived from ventral primary rami of S1 through S4 and also include a component of the lumbosacral trunk, which has fibers from L4 and L5. Now, those sacral spinal nerves are going to traverse the sacral canal. Here we're looking at a posterior view of the sacrum. And then they're going to exit through the anterior sacral foramina on the ventral surface of the sacrum. Kind of like that. These dorsal or posterior sacral foramina are for the dorsal primary rami of those sacral nerves. Over here on the pelvis, we can see the sacrum in situ, and we can see the anterior sacral foramina, well, at least some of them, positioned there. Here we can see a hemipelvis, a left hemipelvis, and let's outline for us the lumbosacral trunk coming down again. The lumbosacral trunk is conducting fibers of L4 and L5. Here we have the first sacral nerve's VPR, so that's S1. Here is S2. There is S3. And this itty-bitty is S4. Now, in other contexts, we've described how various branches from either the sympathetic trunk, so sacral splenics, or branches of these ventral primary rami that are parasympathetic, i.e. Pelvic splenics, are going to contribute to the inferior hypogastric plexus. But let's keep this somatic. So derived from branches of S2, 3, and 4, we are going to see a pudendal nerve. That pudendal nerve is going to exit the pelvis through the greater sciatic foramen. It's going to wrap around the ischial spine, and it's going to conduct itself through the lesser sciatic foramen as it travels into the pudendal canal or Alcock's canal. Now, let me give you a few points of orientation here, just so we can sort of understand it. Behind these ventral primary rami, I'll just kind of run over them here. This is the piriformis muscle. I always misspell this with a Y. Piriformis muscle. Here is the ischiococcygeus muscle, or just the coccygeal muscle. And coming down here from the tendinous arc of levator ani across is going to be the iliococcygeus muscle, or the iliococcygeus part of levator ani. And we can see, right, let's go back to there, that proximal part of the pudendal nerve as it's diving down sort of behind these muscles. Here is a view of the perineum in lithotomy position. Let's give us a little context here. So here would be the vestibule of the vagina with the labia minora. Here is the anal canal with the external anal sphincter. Here's the pudendal canal there. And let's take a look at what's coming through here. So we've got the pudendal nerve and some of its branches. In fact, some of these branches, in particular, the inferior rectal, are going to branch off in the pudendal canal to serve the external anal sphincter. And then we'll have a variety of other branches of the pudendal nerve. So for instance, here we have, that's the posterior labial nerve, which is of the superficial perineal nerve. That's sensory from the perineum. Here's the deep perineal going under the membrane. That is going to be motor to the ischiocavernosus muscle and bulbocavernosus muscle. And then rounding it out, we've got the dorsal nerve of the clitoris. So this is the pudendal nerve in a nutshell. And for this session, you are in particular responsible for these inferior rectal nerves, sometimes called inferior anal nerves. So that's the sacral plexus and the pudendal nerve in particular. We'll go into greater detail of some of the derivatives of the sacral plexus, like the sciatic nerve and its components, and some of the other nerves which serve the hip in MSK. Thank you very much for your time.